Through the process of evolution, many different organisms arise, some more complex than the others. These organisms have more and more functions that evolved and passed on to the next generation. And these functions themselves were passed on through DNA, which can basically make a copy of itself and pass it on to its daughter cell. Imagine it like this. The DNA is a piece of paper with a set of instructions on it, and the process of replication is copying this A4 into sheets and giving on the information. Depending on how much information there is, all of it cannot fit on one page, or let's say one set of DNA. This is when you get chromosomes, which are densely packed version of the DNA, similar to a page bound together in a book. There is a collection of individual pages. Now, humans have 46 chromosomes, so one can imagine that the replication and segregation of this kind of information would be quite difficult. Imagine making copies of these 46 books, segregating them into individual sections. This sounds like a complex task. Now, luckily, our cells have managed to design a system that allows for the segregation, in which you have these individual chromosomes being segregated to different ends of the cell, which allows them to be sectioned into the daughter cells. But this wasn't always the case. Now, the early organisms did not have a whole lot of DNA. And so, from this one copy during replication, it probably was able to split, like opening a zipper, and then make new copies along these separating lines. At some point, these individual molecules of DNA became much longer and longer. It made more sense for the cell to crumple it up and compact it in the form of a chromosome. However, even chromosome would go on further at some point to become even longer and longer, making it quite difficult to manage the entire thing. And so that's when you have splitting up of the chromosomes into multiple chromosomes. We basically go from a sheet of paper with information to a book, and now we have multiple stacks of books. One of the biggest plus points of having all of this information is that you can definitely keep on having more information. It's like having more books in your library. And this information gives rise to all of the complexity that we see today. It is definitely a big task to maintain this complexity and all of this information. So, in my research, I want to find out, when was it beneficial to have these multiple chromosomes at the risk of losing one of them during cell division? In other words, why would we have the encyclopedia of life's information split up in different books, even when it's much more work distributing all of these different books? In my experiments, I'm going to take bacteria which have been genetically modified such that they are resistant to different antibiotics. What I will do next is to fuse the cells together, which will result in a compartment that contains more DNA than was present before. Now we can observe these newly formed cells and how they undergo duplication to give rise to new daughter cells. What can happen in this case is there will be some daughter cells with the right combination of the required DNA to survive in the antibiotic selection that we have. But in other cases, there might not be enough DNA for survival. Over many generations of selection, we will end up with a population that has the right kind of information in order to survive, because essentially, over time, we are killing off everything else. One possible outcome of the cell having all of this DNA in its cell can result in, over time, of course, that the daughter cells will lose this redundant part and simply keep the parts that are different. In other words, you don't want to have the same chapter giving you the same information in two different books. A more extreme version of this gene loss, let's say, is that one of the chromosomes, only the part that is unique, is the one that remains. A third possibility is that the chromosomes are able to physically link to one another, thereby ensuring they always remain in the same compartment. Which of these hypotheses come true, we don't know. There might also be additional solutions. What we do know for now is that if you cannot compact your DNA into one package, then you need to be very sure that the two packages, the different packages that you have, are going to the same place, so that you end up with all of the required information that you need to survive. In other words, if you cannot fit your entire story in one book, then you need to make sure that you publish all of your volumes and distribute them at the same time, so that you have the whole story.